Have you ever seen a photo where sky looks so silky or water looks so smooth, almost unreal? This technique is called long exposure photography, where the camera shutter remains open for a long period of time and it registers every single moment in the frame while focusing on the still objects. But this can be done by the photographer at the very moment. What if you already have an image and you want to achieve the long exposure effect into that photo? Is it too late for that? Worry not, my friend. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you step-by-step guide, easy to understand the technique, how to achieve that look in Photoshop. Not only that, you will also get to know how to remove the sky like a pro from the complicated objects and how to create a realistic reflection in the water. So without any further ado, let's jump into the tutorial. So here we go, our image, and then we have our new sky there. So I'm going to double click on this layer to get this blend diff option out. So by gray, because my sky is gray, I'm going to take out all the highlights so you can see our new sky there. When you see all those nice sharp edges, just simply press Alt or Option from the keyboard and click on this icon to break this apart and slightly move in on the left side and on the right side till you can see the edges are nicely blended with the background. Up to this point that is fine, and I press OK. Now if I take the, let me turn this off. So I'm going to right click on this layer and convert it into a smart object. Now by selecting the magic wand tool, I click on this area and you get this nice selection. I'm going to turn this layer off and get this layer back on. Click. Now you can see you have a nice selection there. So in order to remove this selection, I'm going to select the selection marquee tool and press shift from the keyboard and add this selection into my main selection. And here you can see the sky has been nicely selected. Now remove this layer, we don't need that no more. And on this layer, let me convert into a smart object. So we have this nice selection on. If I press, and I'm going to press Ctrl Shift I to revert the selection. Now you can see the whole image is selected, and I'm going to click on the mask icon. Let me turn my sky layer on to see what is happening here. So we got some whiteness here and there. All those edges needs to be taken care of. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to press Ctrl J from the keyboard and convert this into a smart object again. Now I turn off this layer and select the new copy layer and double click on it. Now I'm going to focus on these areas only. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take highlights all the way to where I see it is completely start vanishing from the screen. Well, you will lose some details here and there, but this is, it has been so zoomed in, so you can see all those pixels there. So I'm going to press Alt from the keyboard and click on this icon to break it apart. And now you can see it is nicely blended with the background up to the point where you see you are happy with the pixel. Press OK. Now you can see we have all those trees nicely blended with the background. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to convert this layer into a smart object again. Press Ctrl from the keyboard and click on this layer, and I get this selection again. Now we don't need this layer. All I needed was this selection. So I'm going to remove this layer by this, and I turn my layer back on again. Now I have my selection on. Make sure you have select the mask and zoom in. Now I select the brush and my foreground color is black, and right click and select the soft rounded brush. So by selecting the mask, if I zoom in and remove all these areas, you see what is happening here. This is basically my tree is getting removed. But we don't want to do that. Why? Because the selection is around the trees, but I want the selection to be inverse. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to press Ctrl Shift I to reverse the selection, and now I'm going to paint on these areas, and you see what is happening. I'm just painting on those areas, so wherever you see those extra colors which is not blending nicely with the background, that can be removed. Let me press Ctrl H or Command H from the keyboard to hide the selection so you know what I'm doing here. I'm just painting on those areas. You see all the whiteness are slightly removing from the background. from the tree, and those trees are nicely blended with the background. So in this area and these areas you can decrease the size of the brush. And these areas, and then these areas. Just to let you know, my selection is still active. You can't see it because it's hidden, but it's still active. And that's it. And once you're happy with it, press Ctrl 0 to see the whole picture. Let me press Ctrl H again to see the selection. Now it's all been done. We don't need the selection anymore. I'm going to press Ctrl D. Now the sky is nicely removed from the image. Now the next part is our sky. How can we create the long exposure effect into our sky? So let me turn this layer off for now, and I select this layer. So now I'm going to show you a technique to create the smoothie silky sky. How do we do that? Select this sky and I go to filter, but before that, just right click on this layer and convert it to a smart object. So go to filter and blur gallery and then path blur. So here I'm going to press this reset button. So I'm going to click once on the screen, and you can see it is waiting for me to click twice. So if I click this area, now it defines the direction of the blur, in which direction the blur should be. Once you're happy with, simply press escape from the keyboard. And now you can see the sky is moving slightly towards the right. If I increase the speed, now you can see that blurry effect is coming in to make the sky more smoother. You can see the effect. So if I reduce it up to here, that is fine. You can also control the wind direction here too. So if I simply click on this icon and move out, you can see how the sky lines are moving. Just move it around and play with it, and you will get to know how these things are working. Same, it goes on both ways, and move those points. Now you see basically what is happening. You are basically determines the wind direction, how the sky is moving. So I'm going to press reset again to create the effect again. So I click here and I click there once. Now you have two points there, and you can determine which way you want this blur to be. So now I'm going to press escape from the keyboard. Now you can see the direction has been defined. I slightly bend it a bit and increase the speed so you can get the nice blurry effect. What if I add the wind direction up to this point? And once you're happy with it, press OK. And now if I turn on my main layer, so you can see how nicely you have created the effect. But there's a problem here. If you just pay attention on the water, you can see the reflection of the old sky. The old sky is not matching with the new sky. So what are we going to do? We are going to create a new reflection which can reflect the new sky into the water. So how do we do that? So I'm going to press Ctrl Shift Alt and E from the keyboard. You can press the command option shift and E for the Mac users, and you can get a stamped visible layer. But I want this layer on top of this layer, so you can see I have made a copy of all the layers into a new layer. And now I'm going to right click on this layer and convert into a smart object. So now I'm going to press Ctrl T, and you see this dot here, set this dot into here. That's where I want my image to be flipped. I right click on this layer and vertical, and you see my image has been flipped vertically where I have set that dot point. Now let me turn this layer off for a moment, and I'm going to select pen tool from a side, and I start making a rough selection. You don't have to be very precise, just make a rough selection, and this here, here. I'm just making a quick selection to get you the idea how nicely and easily this can be done. Okay, once you're happy with it, let me zoom out and let me complete my path. and let me turn this layer on. And now I'm going to press Ctrl or Command for the keyboard to create that vector mask. Now you can see the exact reflection in the water, but it doesn't look realistic. So what do? We need to create that ripple effects in the water so this reflection look more realistic. Press Escape to get rid from this mask, and I select this layer and I select the move tool and I press Ctrl T. And now I'm setting this point here. If you can't see this point here, this is where it come from. You see, if I click here, you can see my point is back to normal. That's where it is. Just set this point here where this reflection begins and press Alt from the keyboard and move in. So basically what is happening, the image is shrinking on the both side. So when you press Alt and you shrink the image or you resize the image one side, it will apply the same resizing or transformation on the other side of the image. Same applies for the horizontal and vertical. So once you're happy with the whole image, press Enter. Now it's time to create the ripple effect. We are going to create a new file by clicking New, and the width is 500 by 1070 ppi. Press OK. We have created a new document with this black background, which really doesn't matter. Just simply unlock the layer by double clicking on it and get this layer style option on. So here you can see, if you just go to the pattern overlay, you can see this water effect. So basically I'm looking for a nice texture effect here to create that distortion into the water reflection. Let's select any of these water. I think that should be fine. Just scale it a bit more. That should be okay. Press OK. And once you're happy with it, create a new layer by Ctrl Shift N and merge these layers completely together so we won't be able to edit them again. So press Ctrl E and this has been merged both together. Now press Ctrl T from the keyboard, right click on it and select perspective, zoom out and take it all the way out. Let me take it all the way out. If I press Enter, now you can see what is happening here. You are basically creating the perspective into the water. You can see all those layers in front, and further you go back, all those details are getting diminished into the perspective. So I'm going to press Ctrl S to save this document, and I call it Ripple, and I press Save. Now I press Ctrl W to close this document, and I come back to my main image. Now selecting the image, go to Filter, Distort, and Displace Filter. I have set 20 and 80, press OK, and make sure you have set these values there, and you press OK. Now it will ask you, now I'm going to select the same file I just created, this ripple file, and open it. And here you can see, if you zoom in, you have created the nice effect into the background. As this is our smart object, we can change the settings anytime we like. If we simply double click on this displacement filter, and you can set the values here, and let's see how it turns out to be. And press OK and select that file again. And you see how the effect is creating. Let me slightly zoom in. What if I apply a motion blur here? Maybe. Yeah, a little more. That should be a bit more. Okay, up to this point is fine. Let me zoom out. Now you can see the reflection has been created almost there, but all we need to create are slightly up and down into the water so it looks more realistic. So I'm going to link this layer and I'm going to create a new curve adjustment layer. And here you can decrease it all the way down to create those shadows. And once you're happy, press OK. Now you can see the curve adjustment is affecting the whole image, and we don't want to do that. So we only want to limit this curve adjustment to the layer underneath. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to press Alt from the keyboard and click on this layer. In between this layer, you can see the icon has been changed. Once you click on it, you can see the curve adjustment is only applied into this image only. It is not affecting rest of the image. So let me zoom in a bit. Once you're happy with it, select the mask and press Ctrl I to revert the mask. So basically you can't see anything over here. I'm going to select B from the keyboard and select the brush, right click on it, soft rounded brush, and take the size around. And my foreground color should be white, and I slightly paint on these areas. So if I press all on the keyboard and click, this is what's happening. So I'm only applying that darkness curve adjustment layer effect onto those areas only. Similarly, I need to create some lightness into the water as well to make it more realistically. So I'm going to create another curve adjustment layer by clicking on this icon. Where is it? Here. And now I drag it all the way up. Same thing. You can apply the same clipping mask option from here, so it only affect the layer underneath. So once you're happy with it, select the mask, press Ctrl I again, select the brush from the hair, and this time just paint on the highlights. Click once and press Shift and click on the other side. And now this look more realistic. Now the only problem here is if I zoom in and you see this layer, if I just turn this layer on and hide all the layers, you can see all the hard edges there. We need to diffuse these edges so it can blend nicely with the image. So how can we do that? So simply double click on the mask layer and you see the mask properties here. I need to increase the feather a bit more. So let me zoom in so you know what is happening here. If I zoom in, here we go. Now you see it is nicely blended with the image, and you see how nicely you have created the long exposure of the sky and how realistically you have created the reflection into the water. Let's add some final touch to finish this image. Press Ctrl Alt Shift E to create a stem visible layer, and I'm going to convert this image into a smart object, and I'm going to add a little noise here so it may look a bit more realistic. I think 2-3 should be fine. And go to filter, and this time I'm going to go for camera raw filter. So let me play around with the slider a bit. I'm happy with it. Press OK. So that's it, guys. I hope you have learned something out of this today. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye now.